All right, welcome to the Missouri Association for College Admissions Counseling Virtual College Fair. Thank you for joining us today. A few housekeeping announcements before we get started. You can use the Q&A button on your screen to type questions to our presenters at any time. Your cameras and microphones are off, so the panelists cannot see or hear you. So you can make sure to use that Q&A to chat with them. This is just one of the many sessions happening, so make sure to sign up for more. And this presentation is also being recorded and will be available within about a week at strivescan.com/Missouri. Excellent. So now I will hand it off to our first presenter for the evening, Matt from Milwaukee Institute of Art and Design.
Awesome. Good evening, everybody. It's me, Matt from MIAD. That's the Milwaukee. In downtown Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Excuse me there. Let me get my presentation going for you. All right. So there we are, Milwaukee Institute of Art and Design. That's us right here. We're essentially a one building campus, 245,000 square feet of creative space in a historic warehouse in Milwaukee's creative district, the historic Third Ward. We are a specialized school of art and design, exclusively visual arts and design, exclusively undergraduate. So we have five majors and they all lead to a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree. We are an independent, nonprofit, private college, and we're the only college like us in the state of Wisconsin. Milwaukee is on Lake Michigan. We're about an hour and a half, 2 hours north of Chicago, and the cities are set up very similarly, if you're familiar with Chicago at all. Definitely cold up here in the winter, but the warm weather months are incredible. And as things kind of get back to normal, we'll be back to what Milwaukee's known for, which is the city of festivals, the city of get-togethers, a very fun social place. As I mentioned, our neighborhood is the creative district of the city. So that means there's the commercial gallery scene is here, as well as a number of advertising agencies, other types of creative firms, architectural agencies. It's a very good place to be an art and design school, a very great place to be located. It is downtown, and it's considered the safest district of the city as well. And even though it's historic, our residence hall is not. This is a much newer building. So should you be coming from out of state, say Missouri, you would get the opportunity to live here. Although I understand we're talking to a transfer student audience, so actually you wouldn't have to live here if you're coming in as a junior or over the age of 21. But for those who would be, it is apartment style living. You would share an apartment with four or five other of your students right across the street from MIAD, a shared kitchen and living room space, bedroom spaces, two bathrooms, quite nice. Just a couple facts about the building. Generally speaking, we're about 930, 900-ish full-time degree-seeking students. We cap our classes at 18, so that teacher-to-student ratio of 16 to 1 is our average. And again, lots and lots of open creative space for everybody to use. Great link right here. I can share this in the chat, but for the transfer students who need more information about transferring to an art and design school, which is a pretty specific thing, MIAD.edu/admissions/transfer students. This is how you find it. Click on admissions, click on transferring to MIAD. And this really awesome table, a couple tables actually. I'm just showing you the one for studio credits, the art and design credits. But this just gives you an idea of the types of things that we're looking for to at least get you in as a sophomore. And that's when MIAD's majors start. So the sophomore through the senior year is when you're in a specific discipline. That could be new studio practice, which is our fine arts major. It's an example of a fine arts studio there. Everything else is going to be on the design side of things at MIAD. So communication design is essentially our graphic design, our visual communications discipline, which is definitely very transferable, especially at the two-year technical and community college level. There's just a lot of transferability there. Here's some alumni work. We're pretty proud that the new Milwaukee Bucks identity design branding was done by an agency and head by one of our graduates. The agency's actually out of New York. Illustration being the most popular major at MIAD now, has a lot in common with communication design, a lot of the same sort of commercial context, similar types of problem solving, but illustrators are very, very dedicated to the development of original image to solve problems. So a lot of other things end up in that major as well, like using narrative, character-driven narrative, concept art, et cetera. Some great example of some alumni work there from Gabriela Riveros, who did the campaign art for the 2016 Milwaukee Film Festival. Yes, we have a film festival every year in Milwaukee. Now onto the 3D design majors. Product design is what it sounds like. Technically, this discipline is known as industrial design, but we refer to it as product design at MIAD. So you, the audience, know what we're talking about. So that's consumer products, everything from, you know, the water bottle I'm drinking out of, somebody empathized with me about these materials and the shape and experience, all the way up to things like vehicles. Harley Davidson is based out of Milwaukee. They're a partner of ours. I graduated with Ben McGinley in 2010. He's been at Harley Davidson ever since, in charge of their electric line right now, which you may have seen in Age of Ultron, in a scene featuring Black Widow. Last but not least, interior architecture and design. Quite a bit of syllables in that major, but like many things at MIAD, they cover a lot of ground. So from the scale of our bodies and how it relates to furniture and fixtures, and how furniture and fixtures relate to the shape of a room, how rooms are determined by buildings and buildings are determined by landscapes. Really, that whole dialogue is covered in this discipline. If any of that sounded exciting and interesting and cool to you, applying to MIAD is very straightforward. It is a free application. We absolutely want you to use the admissions experience as a way to get your questions answered, as a way to see if your creative goals can be met at a creative community like MIAD. So please don't hesitate to apply, especially transfer students. Don't hesitate to apply any time of year. I am very, very used to working with transfer students year round. I am the assistant director of transfer admissions at MIAD. I don't think I mentioned that initially, so I would be the counselor to any and all transfer students, and I will help you get your portfolio together. That is a unique part of applying to art school. You're going to hear that from Kansas City Art Institute as well. We do look at your visual skills as well as your transcripts from both college and high school. Everything else is optional. Again, this is me, Matthew Sothen at MIAD.edu, and I look forward to getting to know you and your work. Thanks.
Excellent. Thank you, Matt. Next up, we have Rick from Illinois College.
Good evening, everybody. I'm going to try and share my screen here. And my name is Rick Bistry, and I'm with the admissions office at Illinois College, located in Jacksonville, Illinois. Let me see here. Hang on. Please bear with me. Okay. I'm not going to be able to pull it up. Sorry about that. As I said, my name is Rick Bistry. I'm with the admissions office at Illinois College in Jacksonville. And Jacksonville is about 30 miles straight west of Springfield, Illinois. So we're in the central part of Illinois. Illinois College is a small four-year private liberal arts college. Student enrollment's just a little over 1,000. We were at 1,150 for the fall semester. So we have small classes. Most classes average 17 students in a class and a 13-to-1 student to faculty ratio. So we really stress the small college experience, the opportunity to be involved, get to do things. You're not going to be lost in the crowd. Professors know your name, those types of things that come along with being a smaller school. Even though we're a smaller school, we have a lot of student experiences available that a big university might have. We have students from 32 different states within the U.S. There are students from 26 different countries. 28% of our student body is of color. 37% of our student body is first generation. And we're NCAA Division III, so we have a lot of student athletes. About 45% of our students are athletes. There's over 80 clubs and activities that students can be involved with, and about 75% of our students are involved in those. 87% of our students live on campus, so we're a residential campus. That makes it really, you get the full experience living on your own, being active and involved, and typically you're going to have a lot more fun. Illinois College offers over 50 majors and programs of study. Business, biology, and education would be our largest areas of study. Very strong in the pre-law, pre-med, the pre-professional areas. A lot of students going on to graduate school. So it's a very good mixture of different academic majors and programs available, even though we are a smaller school. 98% of our graduates are employed within 6 months after they graduate, or they're continuing their education on in areas like graduate school, law school, medical school. We feel that it's important at Illinois College that you experience some life-defining experiences, such as internships, student-faculty research, community engagement, and international travel. And remember, once again, because we're a smaller school, you're going to get to do those things. You're not going to be standing in line and left out because too many other students want to do the same experiences. At Illinois College, we provide a lot of academic resources to help support the students academically. We have a TRIO program. We have academic success mentoring, free tutoring, and then career planning. And there's also academic coaches available for all students that are interested. At Illinois College, once again, we guarantee an internship, research, or study abroad if that's what you're interested in doing. Our textbooks are included in tuition, so it's a good value from that standpoint. Very generous scholarships and financial aid programs for transfer students. And as I mentioned previously, an academic coach for every new student. Transfer scholarships range from $12,000 a year to $17,000 a year. Those are renewable. And if you're a Phi Theta Kappa member, you'll receive a $2,000 Phi Theta Kappa scholarship. And we also have scholarships for debate and speech, music, and esports. Illinois College, I'll put our website address in the chat. If you're interested in applying, the application's online, it's free. We need your college transcript to make an admissions decision. And we want to remind you to send your FAFSA information to Illinois College as well. Thank you very much.
Great, thank you so much, Rick. All right, we have Caitlin from Denver. Go ahead.
Unmute myself. Hello, my name is Caitlin Mueller, and I'm an Assistant Director of Admission and Transfer Coordinator at McKendree University. This evening, I'm excited to speak with you about McKendree University. McKendree University is a mid-sized private school in Lebanon, Illinois. McKendree was founded in 1828, and we are the oldest college in Illinois. We maintain the longest standing affiliation with United Methodist Church in the US and embrace students from all religions, ethnicities, and socioeconomic backgrounds. You can meet friends from 40 different states in 40 different countries. 60% of our students do come from the state of Illinois, and 9% are international students. These international students come from countries as far as away as Brazil, Italy, and Thailand. We're located in the charming town of Lebanon, home to about 4,400 people. It's a safe community that has good restaurants, rich history, local businesses, and great community support. At McKendree, we have over 50 academic programs. Some of these programs include biopsychology, cybersecurity, athletic training, sport management, and a plethora of K-12 teaching licensures. You can scan the QR code here to see a full list of our programs. McKendree is a liberal arts institution, meaning you will take classes from all subjects and learn how to think, not what to think. The academic experience is very personalized. All of our classes are faculty taught by an instructor who is accomplished in their field and is invested in your success. Our average class size is 14 students in a class, meaning you will develop close mentoring relationships with your professors. About half of our students will complete an internship in any given year. About half of the students that do complete that in each spring, McKendree does come together for the Academic Excellence Celebration, which was actually today, on which no classes are held and students have the opportunity to present their research findings and share their creative works with our entire community. McKendree is also very proud of our 98% postgraduate success rate across all of our programs. So within 6 months, Bearcat alumni are either employed or enrolled in graduate school. This is one of the best graduate success rates in the entire world. As outside of the classroom, there are no shortages of things to do at McKendree. We have over 80 registered student organizations ranging from honor societies and community service organizations to unique special interest groups and sorority and fraternity life. We are home to the Hetton House Center for the Arts, which brings in guest speakers and artists, in addition to serving as the home to our visual performing arts groups. We are also only 30 minutes away from downtown St. Louis, providing you with endless cultural, recreational, professional opportunities. The restaurants, museums, and parks are fun to explore, and we're able to partner with universities in St. Louis for programs such as our 3+3 pre-law program with SLU and our 3+2 occupational therapy program with Washington University. Excuse me. At McKendree, we are proud members of the NCAA Division II Great Lakes Valley Conference and are able to offer scholarships. Be sure to follow MCK Bearcats on Instagram and Twitter for updates. And for a full list of teams and contact information, please check out mckbearcats.com. As for the application process, you are viewing it at a glance. We offer rolling admissions in which you can apply for free using the McKendree application or the Common application. Once you have submitted your application, you will need to submit all unofficial or official transcripts from all post-secondary institutions attended. Each application is reviewed holistically. And however, to be considered for admission as a transfer student, applicants must have a minimum cumulative GPA of a 2.4 for all completed coursework at the post-secondary level. McKendree gives careful consideration to your previous coursework and transfer in as many credits as possible. Students entering with an associate's degree, provided the degree is not considered vocational, are considered to have met all general education requirements. However, we will accept up to 90 total credits in transfer. Also, you will be able to provide you with an academic completion plan as part of the admission process. And once you've been admitted, your admission counselor will work closely to ensure your seamless transition to McKendree. Right now you are viewing our transfer scholarships. These are decided at the time of admission. So at least a 2.5 will guarantee you an academic scholarship. Of course, we are going to encourage students to submit the FAFSA to see what other additional aid that you might be eligible for. Again, as admission counselors, we'll work with you through the entire financial aid process. Here is some contact information for myself and our other transfer counselor, and we look forward to working with all of you. Thank you so much.
Great, thank you so much, Caitlin. All right, next up we have Julia from Kansas City Art Institute.
Thank you. So I am Senior Academic Affairs Specialist with KCAI, and I work with transfer students, and let's see. So KCAI is located in Kansas City, Missouri, founded in 1885. We're one of the oldest colleges of art and design, and population in Kansas City is about 2 million, so it's a good sized town, not too big, not too small, really easy to get around. And we've been voted as one of the best places to live. And we're a very affordable city. And this is something that I think is really important when thinking about transferring to a college, is the cost of living. On average, students are spending about $300 to $400 a month to live in our neighborhood. This is a shot of our campus. We have a beautiful green acreage, 16 acres of land. We have about 650 students, 9 to 1 student to teacher ratio. So this means a lot of space and a small student population. We're sandwiched right in between two major museums, the Kemper Museum of Art and the Nelson Atkins Historical Museum, which is one of the top 5 museums in the country. And we also have one of the top 5 art scenes in the country. So this is a great place to really kind of launch your career. We have over 150 independent art galleries just in kind of the art center of KC, which is about a 10-minute drive north of our campus in downtown. We do have on-campus housing available for transfer students. They can live on or off campus. There's that flexibility. On-campus dining and a coffee shop, an art supply store. Everything you need is right on our campus. And we also have wonderful amenities for students, ranging from a beautiful woodworking facility. We love craft, we love tradition, we love materials and processes, but we also love technology. We have a fabulous fab lab, which is home to 3D printers, CNC mills, digital Loom, so all kinds of technology available for all of our students. And 100% of our faculty are practicing artists. So from the moment you come in, you're being taught by professionals in the field. And I say we have about 75 full-time faculty, which is a large number for a small institution such as ours. Every single student gets their own studio space from the moment they walk in the door. And the studios are set up to be indicative of the way that a student would use the space. So you can see there's a shot of a painting student in studio. They get their own private studio space from the moment they walk in the door. Now, we are fully accredited, and we also offer a BFA degree, and a BFA degree is 2/3 studio art, 1/3 gen ed, and you can see how that's broken down. We accept up to 63 transfer credits into our program, so the highest level you can enter is a junior level, and the first year is a foundation year. If you have approximately 18 credit hours of art from your colleges that you've attended, then you would apply directly to one of these majors on the left there. There are 11 majors, nicely split between fine art and design. We also offer double majors and minor programs too. We do encourage every student to do at least one internship before they graduate. Most of our majors require an internship, so we have a whole internship department. We have about an 82% success rate of our students having a job either when they graduate or shortly after they graduate in their field. And these are our application requirements. So you go to our website, you apply, it creates a portal for you where you upload your artwork and all the other materials, and we'll waive your high school transcript if you've completed 24 or more college credit hours. And we do award every single accepted student a transfer scholarship. On average, we assist with about half tuition. And then we use the FAFSA to see what additional aid that a student might qualify for. But working with transfer students, my goal is to help you not only get into the college, but also to get the best scholarships and make it as affordable as possible. And this is my contact information here. So feel free to reach out to me with any questions. And I'd be happy to help you with your portfolio too. So you can always email me work and I can help you through the whole process. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you, Julia. All right, next up we have Daniel from Full Sail University.
All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Daniel. I'm part of the outreach team at Full Sail University. Let me go ahead and share my screen. So for those of you who are not familiar with Full Sail University, we are a university of entertainment, media, arts, and technology. We've been around since 1979. And we are a university for creative people. We're very different from a lot of institutions here in the United States. The main reason being that everything we do is project-based and hands-on, even if you're doing an online degree, which we offer. We've been teaching online for over 10 years, so we're no strangers to online education. Even if you're doing online, everything will be hands-on. You will be creating projects most of the times. And on campus, we have out over 110 different environments, including 4 different live venues. We have recording studios, audio temples, film sets, sound stages, pretty much all of these amazing environments where our students can work on their projects and really develop the skills that they will need once they graduate from Full Sail. So what you can see on the slide is our iconic Full Sail archway. And behind that you have Full Sail Live, which is where orientation and graduation take place, and also where we film WWE's NXT on a weekly basis. So we're located in Winter Park, Florida. For those of you who are not familiar, we are a suburb in the city of Orlando. We're about 30 minutes away from Disney World and Universal Studios, an hour drive to the beach, couple hours drive to Tampa and Jacksonville, and only a 4-hour drive to the city of Miami. We offer 8 areas of study. So we have music and recording, games, art and film, technology, media and communications, business and sports. And one thing I'll tell you right off the bat is that we're not a performing arts school. So we're not going to teach you how to sing, how to dance, how to play instruments. If you already know how to do this, that's fine. You can certainly bring those skills to the table when you're working on your projects. But we focus on teaching you how to make these things, how to make music, how to make video games, how to make movies, and so on. We're very proud of our grads at Full Sail University. In fact, for the past 20 years or so, we've had grads credited in the Grammys, the Oscars, and the Video Game Awards. 57 Full Sail grads in the Grammys this year, 148 Full Sail grads in the Oscars last year. And also last year, we had about 271 Full Sail grads credited in Video Game Award nominated projects. So I bet with only this information that I've been able to give you, you guys can tell that we're very different from a lot of schools. And this is very true for a variety of reasons. I'll narrow it down to four. So you can actually complete a bachelor's degree in as little as 20 months, right? That is 1 year and 8 months on campus, and 29 months online, so 2 years and 5 months. The reason behind this being that if you're going to be a film producer, music producer, game designer, whatever the case is, you are not just going to go to work a couple hours a day. So we actually have you come to school about 8 to 9 hours every day, 5 to 6 days a week. And this really gives you the time to work on and develop your projects in a very professional manner. Also, we have starts every single month or every 4 weeks to be more specific. So you don't have to wait for fall semester or summer or spring. You can actually get started whenever you'd like at Full Sail. We also have career support or career development. These would be the people helping you with writing your resume, searching for jobs, practicing for job interviews, and things of that nature. And of course, we have project portfolio classes. So these are 7 classes embedded into each of our degree programs that serve as checkpoints. This is where you stop and analyze everything you've done up to that point, and you start working towards something tangible that you can show prospect employers upon graduation. We're also very big fans of technology at Full Sail. So we have Project Launchbox. So Project Launchbox is a technology package that we include with each of our degree programs. The one I'm showing you right now is for our music production degree. So you can see it includes a MacBook Pro, Logic Pro, Pro Tools, a microphone, headphone, MIDI keyboard, digital interface. So even if you're working online, you will receive all these things that make your experience very much hands-on. Again, this is included in tuition, and of course it is yours to keep after you graduate. So you have a very powerful workstation even after leaving Full Sail. So one thing I want to show you real quick is a video just highlighting some of our most prominent grads and some of the most important projects that they worked on throughout their degree, throughout their career, rather. Let's take a look at that.
I realized at a young age that I really liked music. Just from birth, I wanted to do R&B, hip hop, pop type music.
Coming to work at Pixar every day, I never go like, oh God, I gotta go to work today. It's more like, oh God, this is awesome. I'm gonna go to work and I get to work on this thing, I get to work with these people, I get to work, you know, in this environment. And it's just, it's magic, I love it.
I remember playing Legend of Zelda and suddenly feeling like I was inside of a world. And it was just like this big story, and I'm like, I want to do this. Like, I want to know how to do that. I want to make that.
When I called my sister and told her that I was working on Harry Potter and she started screaming, that kind of made me go, oh right. Like, this is a universe that people are like insane about.
I do recall messing around and shooting my own stuff, playing with Dad's video camera, which was, you know, back then size of a suitcase.
You know, when I was growing up, I just kind of was in my own little creative bubble. I kind of did what I wanted. I made all kinds of little worlds, and everything was about being creative and art.
Dream big. Do what you love. I don't care. Dancing, singing, bang a drum, dream big, do what you love. You are destined to be successful if you do that.
So if you're serious about your dream, we'll take your dream seriously. That is our motto at Full Sail University. And I want to thank you guys for your time and attention. If you want to reach out to me directly, you can do so via email or via telephone. You have my information on the screen. Thank you so much. I'll also drop my information in the chat. And if you guys have any questions, please remember to use the Q&A feature. I'll be more than happy to answer anything you have to ask. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you, Daniel. Next up, we have Mackenzie from Millikin University.
Well, it's going to be a little hard to follow that up. That was a pretty awesome video to end on. But I'm going to share my screen here real quick and just give you some general information about Millikin. All right, my name is Mackenzie Larrick. I am the Senior Transfer Admission Counselor here at Millikin. If you are not familiar with Millikin, we are a small private university located in Decatur, Illinois. If you're not familiar with Decatur, we are located right smack dab in the middle of central Illinois. We're a mid-sized city of about 76,000 people. So I think it's kind of the perfect size when you're considering transitioning to a new city. It's not so big that it's overwhelming, but not so small that you might be bored. If you wanna learn more about the Decatur community, I recommend visiting that limitlessdecatur.com webpage listed down there in the bottom left corner. It talks about all of the exciting things going on in our community. I also like to mention some of those top area employers listed there in the center of this slide. These are really great when we think about possible volunteer or internship opportunities. Millikin is very focused on what we call performance learning. I like to call this learning by doing instead of learning by listening or watching. So definitely thinking about local employers and how we can get involved with them and take advantage of those partnerships is really important to us. So here's a little bit of Millikin at a glance. If you don't know anything about us, this is kind of the general information. We have about 2,000 students currently enrolled at Millikin. We do have a 95% graduate success rate. We're very proud of this. This means that 95% of our students either gain employment or enter graduate school within 6 months of graduation. We do have over 50 academic programs, including 3 graduate programs. Those are kind of ever-growing, ever-changing with the trends of employment. We try to keep up with the demand of what students need. 20% of our student body is actually transfer students, including our international transfer students that come from 37 different countries. So you definitely won't be alone in your transition here. That population has been growing steadily over the last 5 years. We do have 23 men's and women's Division III sports in the CCIW conference, 6 sororities, 5 fraternities, 16 student-run ventures, and the 10-to-1 student-to-faculty ratio is one of my favorite things about Millikin. I am a Millikin alum, and that was one of the best parts of my experience, was that individual attention that I got from my faculty members. They're really invested in you. They care about you and your success a lot. The other great thing is that our academic advising teams are actually faculty members within the different departments within your major, so they're fully invested in your education. They're the faculty members that are teaching you every day. They're going to know your face. They're going to know your name. They're going to care about what happens with you. And we do award over $44 million in financial aid, with the average financial aid award being $15,000. I do encourage everyone, even if the tuition price looks intimidating, go ahead and go through the admission process, get up to the point of financial aid, because we do have a lot of generous donors that allow us to come back and offer additional Millikin-funded scholarship and grant opportunities. We do have 4 colleges and schools here at Millikin: the College of Arts and Sciences, the College of Fine Arts, the College of Professional Studies, and the Tabor School of Business. So obviously your major program would fall within one of these colleges and schools, but we think it's really important that you get that well-rounded real-world experience. We want you to have a comprehensive education. So as you're completing those sort of general education, what we call university studies requirements, you're gonna have the opportunity to take classes across all of these different colleges and schools to get a little bit of experience in everything. This often helps students discover if they want to tack on a minor or maybe a certificate, or possibly just figure out what sort of career field they're looking to go into. So campus life is a really exciting part of our campus community. We have a very vibrant, inclusive campus community. I think it comes with being a small, private, close-knit community. Our students are very, very involved. On average, our students are involved in about 3 student organizations at a time. And we do have over 90 student organizations here on campus. So for being a smaller institution, we've got a lot to offer for our students. But the other great thing is that if you can't find something within those 90 student organizations that piques your interest or finds your niche of people, all you have to do is find 5 friends and a faculty advisor, and you can actually create your own student organization. So I think that's how we ended up with almost 100 student organizations. But we really want you to make Millikin your own. We want you to have whatever kind of experience you're looking for, and we do have the staff and the resources to support you in that transition. So if you're interested in applying to Millikin, there are 2 ways to apply. You can apply for free on our website, millikin.edu/apply, or we do also accept the Transfer Common App. For transfer applicants, the only requirements that we have for credentials are all official college transcripts from each institution that you've attended. We do not require anything from high school. We do have a rolling application deadline, which means we will actually work with students up until just a couple weeks before the semester starts. We know that sometimes transfer students are on a later timeline, and we want to give you plenty of time to get in and make Millikin work for you. We are currently still accepting applications for the fall 2021 semester. For spring 22 and fall 22, that will open after July 1st. And I will leave this up for just a minute. This is my contact information. If you want to know more about transferring to Millikin, setting up a visit, any information, anything like that, please feel free to reach out to me.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Mackenzie. And now I would love to invite all of our presenters to turn on their cameras. And we'll have a few moments for a Q&A. And so, perfect. And I will start with a question for any one of you to answer. What advice would you give someone going through the transfer process? Anyone can.
The one thing I would mention is don't be afraid to look at transferring. And there's a lot of myths out there about how hard it is to transfer, that you're going to lose credits and there's not scholarships and financial aid. Work with the transfer coordinators at the school, because we do provide a lot of help and assistance, and the transfer process can be a very smooth and easy process.
Yeah, absolutely. Just following up on that, just starting the conversation, having a conversation as soon as you start thinking about it, because a lot of those things can come up if they're not caught super early. So we can kind of advise you and make sure that you're heading towards a balanced or comfortable transfer experience.
I would agree. Definitely planning ahead is really important if you can. That's probably the easiest transition, is when you plan ahead and you work with the school, especially if you're in a community college and you already know where you want to go in the future. Usually we can advise, like you said, and help you prepare for that transition to make it as smooth as possible.
All right. I'll go to the next question, because I would love to ask all of you this. I'll start with Caitlin. What is your favorite event or tradition on campus?
So I may have mentioned it during the presentation, but we have an event called Academic Excellence Day, and it was actually 2-day, and we cancel classes. We don't even have campus visits that day because faculty, staff, and students are encouraged to attend presentations, different performances. It's really a culmination, or really more than that, of a student's work. So it's every discipline, every major is represented, and it's really an opportunity for our students to showcase everything they've done. I mean, students that we know and have worked with as they were incoming, and to see them develop while they're at McKendree and really put themselves out there. We ended the day with our choir and our band on the front lawn. It was gorgeous outside, so it really is my favorite day, because really it's about the students and we're celebrating them, the inductions in the Honor Society. So it's a full day, and it's just excited because as we're getting close to graduation, we know that most of our students are going to be leaving us soon, and they're going to go off and do great things.
Excellent. Mackenzie?
Sorry, if I can unmute myself, right? When you just slip right over that button. So we have an event that we call Cookie Party. So it is finals week right before winter break, where basically all of the faculty and staff that want to volunteer bake cookies and bring dozens and dozens of cookies into our University Commons building. And all of the students, staff, faculty come in. We usually have Christmas music, holiday music playing. And it's just a time for everybody to kind of get together before we go on that break. And I think we've been doing it for 80 some years now. So it's been a pretty awesome tradition here. And all the students are always looking forward to Cookie Party when we go into the winter. So we all kind of love that event.
Perfect. Daniel.
So I would have to say my favorite tradition at Full Sail University, we're an Apple Distinguished School. So we use Apple technology for a lot of our degree programs. So during orientation, when every student has his or her lunchbox, they all take out the computers at the same time, and it's a huge room. So there's like 200 people, and they all open their computers and press the power button at the same time. So it's like the Apple chime echoing through the whole hallway, and it marks the beginning of the students' journey at Full Sail. So it's very symbolic, and I just like it. It has a very good vibe to it.
Perfect. Excellent. Julia?
So twice a year, at the end of every semester, we open up our whole campus to the community, and every student exhibits their work. It's our end of semester show and sale, and Friday night, we literally have lines going down the street of people in the community that want to come in and support our students by purchasing their work. So that's, and you know, we have such a large acreage. So we have so many spaces to go through. It usually takes somebody a couple days to get through all the exhibitions on campus in the student studio. So that's my favorite.
Cool. Matt.
It's got to be our senior exhibition, and this is something that's going on right now. It's a little different this year, just given what we've all been going through. There is going to be an online version of it, but you can check it out at senior exhibition.maya.edu. In a typical year, it opens at the same time, and every single graduating senior has their own exhibition space. So we have a day where actually we shut down classes. It's called Maya Define. Because the senior exhibition just really shows us, you know, what's possible at MIAD, who we are, or at least how that generation of students has shaped their program, their discipline to create a professional creative platform for themselves.
And Rick.
Tomorrow is our academic excellence celebration. So we're looking forward to that. But I think the biggest tradition and the one that a lot of alumni come back for, obviously, is homecoming. So, you know, in the fall of the year, hopefully the weather's nice on those Saturdays, but that's a big tradition at Illinois College. A lot of alums come back, and it's great to see everybody come back and celebrate.
Perfect. All right. And last question for everyone as well. Give us an interesting or fun fact about your school. And we'll start off with Caitlin.
So our mascot is the Bearcat, and we have a statue out front, and every student that's incoming will always ask, is this what a Bearcat looks like? And then we have to show them a photo of a past president that actually had a Bearcat sitting on his shoulder, which is very slightly smaller than our statue. So that's sort of a tradition that the president likes to show the photo to incoming students, usually when he's handing out free ice cream. So if anyone knows our president, they either know him as the guy with the bear cat on his shoulder or the man that gives out the free ice cream. So just a little fun fact. On warm days, we look forward to the ice cream cart coming around.
That's awesome. Excellent. Daniel.
So fun fact about Full Sail University, since we do a lot of entertainment stuff, we actually had, back in the day, the Backstreet Boys record one of their albums at Full Sail University. Ariana Grande's Sweetener album was mixed at Full Sail University. And also there's a show on Nat Geo on Disney Plus called The Right Stuff. Part of it was also filmed at Full Sail University. So there's always something going on.
Awesome, perfect. Julia.
So our college started as a sketch club in 1885, and there have been many iterations of it since then, but Disney took classes at our college. So he started at KCAI.
Perfect. Rick.
McKendree was actually founded in 1828. Illinois College was founded a year later, but we were the first college in the state of Illinois to hold classes and the first college in the state of Illinois to graduate a class.
Mackenzie.
So we have two little mermaids who have graduated from Millikin, our Millikin alum. So both Jodie Benson, who was the voice of Disney's Little Mermaid, and Sierra Boggess, who was Broadway's Little Mermaid, are both Millikin alum.
Perfect. And then Matt.
I always have the same answer for this question. one of MIAD's founding fathers is a designer by the name of Brooks Stevens. You can look him up. He's designed many things, still carries a design agency in his name. But my favorite thing that he designed that we like to show off proudly, just right next to the admissions office at MIAD, is the original Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. there you go. Putting Milwaukee on the map.
Perfect. I love it. All right, well, that wraps up the time that we have for today. So thank you all for joining us. When you close this window, there will be a link to a very quick 4-question survey, and we'd appreciate any feedback you can provide. And also, this is one of the many sessions happening, so make sure to sign up for more. And then in about a week, we'll have this available on our website at strivescan.com/Missouri, along with other session recordings. So thank you so much. And thank you to all our presenters today. And you all have a good day. Take care.